Has Elon Musk changed the solar industry?
The fact
yeah,
that
the absolutely.
Well, Elon Musk is considered to be an innovator when it comes to electric cars and spaceflight. And over the years, he swore his devotion to solar energy. But has he actually managed to change the solar industry? Hey, what's up? I'm Jason. And in this video, I want to talk about what Elon Musk and Tesla have done for the solar industry. And the reason I thought that it would be fun to make this video is, well, because to me, it's kind of funny how much Elon Musk talks about his love for solar energy. And at the same time, we rarely think of Elon Musk in connection to solar. More often, it's SpaceX, Tesla cars, batteries, and, well, Twitter. In fact, Solar Roof remains to be one of the Tesla's biggest disappointments. So it's possible that many years later, we'll talk about Musk as the prophet and the godfather for solar energy. Now, at first glance, the most significant solar project from Elon Musk so far has been Solar City. And this is a company founded in 2006 by Musk's cousin Peter and Lyndon Rive. Now, Musk was the main investor and the inspiration for the company, and Solar City initially focused on door-to-door sales of leased systems. Customers would pay no upfront costs, but agreed to purchase the power generated by those panels from the company for 20 years. Now, the business model worked, in a sense. By 2013, Solar City was the leading residential solar installer in the US. By 2015, its installed panels accounted for roughly 28% of non-utility solar installations in the US that year. And at that time, Tesla and Solar City developed a co-marketing relationship. Musk served as the chairman of Solar City. Solar City offered free charging to Tesla Roadster owners at its charging stations and became one of the first installers of the Tesla Powerwall. You know, the home battery. At the same time, the whole business idea of Solar City had a lot of downsides. On one hand, their offer wasn't all that profitable for the customers. Homeowners weren't getting access to tax incentives, such as solar tax credit, because their systems were leased. Sometimes, simple math would show that just paying for electricity from the grid is cheaper than leasing a system from Solar City. Now, while reading forums, I got the impression that Solar City never got respect from their customers, nor from other installers in the industry. And these are probably the reasons why. On the other hand, the way Solar City operated wasn't great for the company either. Their upfront expenses were immense. The company had to pay around $40,000 for each system that they installed. Eventually, they would get this money back through customers. I mean, it's a lease after all. But it wasn't long enough before the company found itself in huge debt. In 2016, it reached $1.5 billion. And this is when Elon Musk stepped in and bought the company. To convince Tesla that Solar City is a good investment, Musk held a famous presentation where he pitched Solar Roof idea. He talked about how roofs made of solar shingles would replace traditional ones, and everyone would get access to renewable energy this way, but we'll come back to that later. So Solar City basically doesn't exist as a brand anymore, and it turned into Tesla Solar. It still offers installation services, but now sells solar panels instead of leasing them. And that's because solar panels became a lot cheaper in the last 10 years, and it's easier for homeowners to afford them. However, it seems that Tesla struggled to integrate Solar City in their company structure. In the fourth quarter of 2017, Tesla Solar reported a 43% drop in solar deployments compared with when it was still Solar City. The company lost its leading position in the market in 2018 and stood for around 2% of the residential solar market. In the first 8 months of 2021, Tesla installed 177 megawatts of solar. That is less than a half of what Solar City was installing per quarter before the acquisition. Tesla Solar also became famous for poor service. Customers complain about how hard it is to reach out to the company and how long you have to wait for contractors to arrive. The installation quality isn't all that great either. For example, Walmart reported that several Tesla Solar installations caught fire. And what is it about Tesla solar roofs that everyone was so excited about? Seems like this idea hasn't taken off yet. This spring, CNBC in their report said that so far, Tesla has only provided 3,000 of those roofs. 3,000. The project was unveiled 7 years ago. In late 2019, the company said it was aiming to manufacture 1,000 solar roofs weekly and to install 1,000 per week in the first half of 2020. None of that's happened. In 2022, the average weekly installations of Tesla solar roof reached just 21, according to NBC. And it's not like the demand isn't there, it's just that the company can't keep up with it. All in all, it seems like Tesla and Musk just aren't doing all that well when it comes to the solar business, isn't it? In my opinion, though, it doesn't mean that they don't make an impact on it. When we talk about Tesla, we mostly talk about electric cars. Since 2020, their Model 3 is the best-selling electric car in world history, and the demand for them only grows. In March 2022, Google reported the all-time highest search interest in electric cars. And if you recall, that's the time when the gasoline started getting really expensive. 80% of electric car owners prefer charging them at home. Frankly, it's a lot of energy. For example, the Model 3 maximum battery size is 75 kilowatt hours. Just to put that into perspective, an average house in the US needs about 30 kilowatt hours per day. How do you pay less for charging, especially with electric rates going up all over the country? Well, you install solar panels. The electric cars that Tesla makes account for about 90% of Tesla's total income. And the rest? Well, about 5% of the income comes from Powerwall sales. Right now, Powerwall 2 is possibly the most popular home battery. The thing about Powerwall is that for a long time, the only way you could charge it was solar energy. So those who lived in areas with a high number of outages and wanted a Powerwall had to install solar panels. So where am I going with this? Well, it seems like Tesla's solar division is struggling. It's hard to deny that Musk and Tesla changed the market of electric cars and home batteries. And these are the products that pair well with solar. When the demand for EVs increases, this should, in theory, impact the solar industry as well. Yes, it's the circumstances, the situation in the world that pushes us towards those electric cars. But hey, someone had to make them first, right? As for Tesla's solar roof, I'm not going to pretend like it's a successful project yet, but I don't want to bash it either. The idea is super cool. If anything, to me, it's more of Elon Musk's dream of what the future should look like. This idea may be too big for its time, but hey, big ideas are often a sign of a brilliant mind, right? Maybe it just needs a few more years. Tesla Solar pulls itself together, and hey, we'll have those solar roofs everywhere. Who knows? Look, I gotta say, Tesla and Elon Musk do a lot for the solar industry and popularization of the very idea of solar energy. Even though to me, their contribution is indirect. I feel like it's also because of them getting solar panels and using solar energy at home, it became something common, practical, normal. And it's one of the reasons why we do what we do, which is sell solar panels and tell everybody how great they are. If you live in America or Canada, I encourage you to go and check out A1 Solar Store and pick some panels for your home. Of course, these are just my thoughts, and I'm curious to hear what you have to say about Tesla Solar and, of course, Elon Musk. Let me know in the comments. Well, that's it for me. I'm Jason. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.